it had its effect for a while, and you had some revelations, but it wasn't perfect, and the dark side took the opportunity to catch you.
Yeah, the biggest problem I always had was I didn't have a father that loved me. He was abusive.
Who has a father?
Right, but when I seen you, you were the father, and I wanted you to love me.
Yes,
you did love me, but it wasn't you that was loving me. It was the Lord through you. But I was still kind of with my feet on this world and wanting that
yes.
man, yeah. that, you know, that human to love me. Do you know what I mean?
I do.
And now, I mean, I know you love me, but it isn't you. It's what we're all supposed to love with. Is
yes.
for God to come through us, not
yes.
for me to love someone.
See, because when you leave the program tonight, you will leave more reassured, but not by me, because I'm only bearing witness to what you already know, so that it awakens.
Well,
so,
I wanted to thank you, and I hope that other people listening will realize, too, that because you're meditating and because you're wanting to live by the Lord's prompting, that life is hard and there are hard times, and you just stand there and you deal with them as you deal with them, and you learn from them. And when you, like you said earlier, when
you grow through them,
then you learn from those mistakes.
You learn through them.
I mean, I made an enormous yeah. mistake when my husband and I divorced. I got involved with a younger man, and while I was involved with him, I would cry and pray that God would help me, because I knew I was doing the wrong thing, but I was completely out of control. I mean, something else, my need or whatever. And all through that, Roy, I knew that God wasn't mad at me. I knew that he forgave me and understood how weak I was. And it sounds strange, but...
But he knew that you were in the grip of something, and you needed to understand and not struggle and let him come in and help you. See, you keep struggling with it and looking to others, including me,
right,
to save you from it, and we cannot. See, and you have to realize that.
You're just such a delight. Anyway... Thank you very much.
It's nice to know you all these years, and it's nice to know finally you kind of come around, and we'll both die happy people.
Yeah.
there's another life. You know it, don't you now?
Oh yeah. I spent 10 days in intensive care because the doctor messed up and nicked my liver, and everything shut down.
I
remember laying there, not really any pain or anything. I think I meditated most of the time, and I remember saying, "Lord, if it's my time, come and take me." I wasn't frightened. I wasn't.
That's delightful. That is the reason why you're still here.